Last season, Charlie Strong's USF Bulls fired off 7 straight wins, climbing to a number 21 ranking. This year, he looks to build off that fast start with a seasoned, healthy quarterback, returning 16 starters and bringing in a fun-and-gun offense. We'll go deep into the 2019 USF Bulls next. This is MOR Chronicle, USF Strong Spring Football 2019. Here's your host, JP Peterson.
Hello and welcome to Chronicle USF Strong. I'm JP Peterson, and it's been a busy few weeks here at the USF Football Complex. Thousands of USF alumni, former players coming back for the spring game. But now it's all about 2019 as we look ahead. And here's what's coming up on the big show. Coming up first, we get a revealing look at the journey of head coach Charlie Strong, a trailblazer in college football coaching history, mentored by some of the biggest names in coaching. Plus, we will talk about this year's Bulls as we go one-on-one with defensive coordinator Brian Jean-Marie. The 2019 mantra, fast and physical, and we saw that. And we will chat with the new offensive coordinator, Kerwin Bell, the former Gator legend, bringing his fun and gun offense that averaged 52 points a game at Valdosta State on the way to winning a national title. Plus, an interesting sit-down with Bulls quarterback Blake Barnett to chat about his compelling journey from nation's top recruit to Alabama starting quarterback and now a father and Bulls senior starter. All right, let's get started and show you some football as the Bulls recently held their spring game out here on campus and the fans turned out strong for Charlie and the boys and they did not disappoint. The 2019 spring game was a celebration of Bulls football past and present as many USF legends returned to campus and hopefully a few more were born. It was the first chance to see number 11 quarterback Blake Barnett working in the new Kerwin Bell fun and gun offense. The 6'5" former Alabama starter went 8-for-16 for 135 yards and a touchdown, one pick. And former Tampa Plant High School star, number 16 Jordan McLeod, solidified his hold on the number 2 quarterback spot. Another redshirt freshman, Octavius Battle from Atlanta, was 8-for-12 for 146 yards and 2 scores. And number 89, senior tight end Mitchell Wilcox, is in line for a big senior season. He had a couple of catches for 90 yards and a score. The Tarpon Springs product loves the new Kerwin Bell offense.
We have the same unit, but I just feel like we got a lot of momentum coming from this spring camp, and I think we're going to take that into the fall. I mean, we've got a lot better, and we've made huge strides from where we were day one of spring camp to till now.
So as you can see, there's plenty of talent here at the University of South Florida, and now it's up to the coaches to mold them into a cohesive unit. And of course, that starts with the head man, Charlie Strong, who has been a pioneer for African Americans in the college football coaching industry. And he's borrowed a little bit of wisdom from each and one of those heavy hitters that he's coached under. He's a 2-time Big East Coach of the Year, a 2-time national champion at the University of Florida, directing the defense. But now, as he enters his third here at USF, the goal is simple: win their first conference football championship.
Let's talk about the state of the USF program. I mean, you guys got to 150 wins faster than any program in the state of Florida. There's some pretty good ones, as you know. You
really good there. One, yes.
You've been in the top 25 the last 3 years. You've been to 4 straight bowl games. Your brand new football facility going in here. I know you want to win that first conference championship. That's your goal. Mm-hmm. What's the state of the program right now at USF as you enter your third year?
You know, JP, I think that when you look at programs, you can never look at a program as where it is. You mm-hmm. always look at it where it can go. And I know this program is a lot of potential here, and we can take it. And it's all about when you look at just the resources and then you look at the players that you bring into the program and just the help that you're going to have. Mm-hmm. And I tell our players all the time, like, we're going to recruit really good players. Mm-hmm. Now, once we recruit these players, it's all about us putting a product on the field that everyone's going to be proud of. From the positive side now, I look at our attitude and I look at how hard our guys are working and just knowing where we can take this program. We need to go to this conference championship. And we have the players. Now it's about us just making sure that we can go get it done.
All right, so let's fast forward to this season and we'll zero in on the offense. You got a new coordinator, Kerwin Bell. Blake is back healthy again. You've got some incredible playmakers in Jordan Cronkright, Johnny Ford, so many good playmakers. How excited are you about this offense? And you've seen some good stuff in the spring so far.
When you look at your offense and you look at all three phases, it's just not just offense. When you look at all three phases, And then with getting a new coordinator, a lot of times when you bring the coordinator in, because of what happened, a lot of players, you know, they're kind of wondering, okay, yeah, is this offense going to be, you know, is it going to fit me? Is it going to be? And what Kerwin has done is that he's if you look at his record, he's always won where he's where he's been. He has an unbelievable track record. So he goes and wins the national championship about Austin, and I think they average what 52 points a game. Yeah. And so now when he came here with just instant credibility.
Yeah. Finally, Coach, we talked a little bit about your mentors. Go a little bit more in depth in there. Is there one maybe head coach that you've worked for that really solidified your coaching philosophy?
You know what was special for me, JP? Growing up in a little small town, you know, I had an uncle that ran a service station. I used to work for him, and just back then, that's when you had to go pump the gas yourself. Yeah. So that was back during the day. But he really taught me how to work. And so then when I decided that, you know what, this is a profession that I'm gonna really enjoy doing, and I want to really get locked into. You know, I look at, and every coach that I work for, all of them have been different in the ways of how they've gone about and winning. And they've had, many of them had great success. You know, like I look at Charlie Pell as a GA for, and you know, you think about him and what he's did at the University of Florida, you know, getting it built. And then Coach Spurrier comes in and just takes it to a different level. Yeah. And what people don't realize about Coach Spurrier a lot of times is really he changed college football.
Yeah, he did.
Because you think about it, it was all 3 yards and a cloud of dust. And, you know, everybody's just trying to hope that, you know, that he just make it 3rd and 3. And then I go work for a guy like Lou Holtz. The thing that Lou did is, like, he just built you from inside out, where it was all about, you know, trust, commitment to excellence, and whether you're caring about your players. And that's where it really, I think that really helped me, because at that time, now here you are, where you really focus and you're locked in on your players.
Yes, it's been a great ride for Charlie so far. He'll be the first to tell you it's far from over. Now, when we come back, we'll tackle the USF 2019 defense. Charlie has directed some of the best in college football history. How will this year's unit do?
This is MOR Chronicle, USF Strong Spring Football 2019. You are watching MOR Chronicle, USF Strong Spring Football 2019.
The USF Bulls are always looking to build their fan base, and this spring they had one of their weekend practices over at Clearwater Central Catholic. A couple of hundred fans came out to cheer on the Bulls, and that outdoor turf really showcased their speed. Running back turned receiver Johnny Ford, among others, had a big day. The Bulls have lots of weapons on offense, but what about that defense? Welcome back. Fast and physical. That's the new mantra for the 2019 Bulls defense, and they showed that off in the spring game with 20 tackles for loss and 15 sacks. Head coach Charlie Strong says that's the new identity. Now they got to make it happen.
All right, you're a defensive guy. You got 5 starters coming back on this defense. You got some work to do there. What do you see in some of the new kids and some of the kids that have stayed? How are they developing in this defense?
You know what really helped us, JP? We only have 5 starters coming back, but we had a lot to play last season. And I always feel like this with any football team, you got to start up front, whether it be the offensive line on offense and the defensive front on defense. And so when you have Livingstone as a guy who's back for us, who's played a lot of football for us, and then Kegler is a guy who's inside, who was a starter some last season for us. Pinckney's a guy that was a starter for us last season, and then Reeves. So you have those 4 guys who are back. So we have some guys. Now it's a matter of us on defense. It's all about on defense. You just got to get lined up. Yeah. You get lined up and you play with good technique, play with good fundamentals, and then guys then go tackle the football.
Yeah.
You know, if you go tackle, and part of our problem last season was, you know, we missed tackles, and then so a 5-yard run turns into a 20-yard run, and that's what we can't allow to happen.
And that happens when you play with more physicality, something defensive coordinator Brian Jean-Marie has seen this spring.
What I read and what I hear, that defense is much more physical in spring, especially in the scrimmages. There have been a few pops here and there, and What is that, as a coordinator, when you see your kids growing up like that and bringing that physical mentality, what does that mean for you?
Oh, it makes me feel, you know, it makes me feel really good because that's football. Yeah. You know, we want to do everything, you know, as far as playing as physical as we can be within the framework of the game. Nothing, you know, obviously dirty or cheap, but we want to play physical, you know, at the line of scrimmage. But we also want to play physical, you know, in the secondary and pass coverage, you know, getting bodies on bodies. And when we're in zone coverage, when they throw the ball, we get plenty of hats to the football. And, you know, that's when turnovers happen. If you feel like you're a physical defense, you're going to get turnovers. You're going to be able to disrupt the quarterback. And, you know, big thing is you're going to be able to play, you know, in front of the chains where you're going to always make sure that you're going to be in, you know, second and long and third and long situations if you just have that physical mentality.
As senior Greg Reeves got moved back to defensive end where he's more comfortable, had three sacks in the spring game, and the Bulls defense also had three picks. All right, when we come back, we'll talk some offense. A new offensive coordinator, Kerwin Bell, bringing his record-breaking offense to USF. Stay with us.
Stay tuned for MOR Chronicle, USF Strong Spring Football 2019. You are watching MOR Chronicle, USF Strong Spring Football 2019.
Well, as part of the USF spring game, fans were able to participate in a family pro day where young fans got to do the variety of drills just like the players do. Rocky the Bull was there. I wonder what he does the 40 in and those big feet. It was a lot of fun and just another way Bulls connect with their fans. Well, the Bulls made huge news this offseason when they acquired the highly sought-after offensive mind of Kerwin Bell, who led Valdosta State to the Division II national championship, averaging over 52 points a game. Now, the new offensive coordinator says he did not bring a magic wand with him, and making this offense more explosive is going to take a lot of hard work. And Kerwin is no stranger to hard work. He showed up at the University of Florida as a walk-on and ended up being a four-year starter, including the SEC Player of the Year in 1984. In 14 pro football seasons, he played everywhere, including the Dolphins, Falcons, and Bucks. In 1999, he finished 5-for-5 with one touchdown and a perfect quarterback rating, the highest in NFL history.
Well, it was just, it sort of starts out as just sort of unbelievable. You know, in my life where I was at as a high school senior, no one in the entire country from Mayo, a little town, one red light town, no one in the entire country offered me a scholarship. And all of a sudden, you know, you look back on your life and you were a four-year starter at the great place like University of Florida. Got a chance then to go and play 13 years professionally all around the world and country and into Canada. And to know that you did that because you didn't give up on your dream. Mm-hmm. There were so many times where I didn't get offered by no one and I could have said, well, it's it, it's over. But I just kept refusing to accept that. And I think that's something that I'm proud about. Is if I look back and say, man, there were so many opportunities to quit. When I got cut seven times by NFL teams that I wasn't good enough, I bounced back up and said, where's the next guy at? Where's the next team at?
So tell me a little bit about your time at Valdosta State. Last year, national champions, 52 points a game. What was that experience like?
Well, it was a great year. You know, it's one of those magical years where really, as an offensive guy, the personnel fit our system perfectly. We had a quarterback that played unbelievable. He counted for 50 touchdowns and only four times he turned it over, 50-4. And then we had all this speed that really fits the system that we run. And so it was a magical year to be able to average 52. You know, I don't know if we'll ever do that again.
So you get here and Blake Barnett is the incumbent starter and he has a great story of his own, a great personal story. Last year, kind of a tale of two halves. When he was healthy, he was great, and the last half of the season was tough for him. How is he assimilating to this offense, and as a person, how do you like working with him? What are his attributes?
Well, I think the one thing is the kid's got all the physical ability in the world, all the tools that you need to be successful at this level. He's a big, strong kid, great arm, very accurate throwing the football. He's very sharp, understands the game of football, just really studies it, puts a lot of time and effort into it. So all those things he has. I think the one thing that he has to get done and naturally in a new system is he got to be able to get to that third, fourth, and fifth progression and a little bit quicker and just get better and better at that just so we can get to those wide open guys, even if it's a check down or a guy in the flats. not force the football. You know, a lot of big strong arm guys like him want to sometimes force it down the field. I was sort of like that.
Yeah.
But we're just trying to teach him to be patient, take what the defense gives us, and let's make positive plays on every snap. And if we can get him to do those things, you know, he's going to make some big plays. Now in this new system, we just got to get him away from making those big sacks, take those losses, or throw those incompletions when he can have completions. So that's what we're looking for, is to correct those things. But I really think he likes this system. I think it fits him probably more than it did last year's system did. So, you know, hopefully we'll just continue to grow and he'll have a great year.
Well, you heard Kerwin talk about his new quarterback, Blake Barnett, here at USF, and what a long, strange trip it has been for Blake, from top recruit in the nation to changing diapers. His incredible story when we come back on USF Strong.
Stay tuned for MOR Chronicle, USF Strong Spring Football 2019. You are watching MOR Chronicle, USF Strong Spring Football 2019.
Well, any good coach will tell you it's not so much focusing on the wins and losses, but about the journey and overcoming the obstacles along the way. And for Blake Barnett, it has been a long and winding road of tough choices and perseverance, from single guy to marriage and fatherhood, and all very much in the public eye. Blake was the nation's top quarterback recruit out of California and chose Alabama over all the top programs in America. He won the starting job but was eventually beaten out by Jalen Hurts, the SEC Offensive Player of the Year and national champion. Then on to Arizona State, where a coaching change led to his departure, and now to USF.
A lot of things in my life have happened since, you know, I was a high school quarterback. And, you know, the process that it's been has really helped me develop to become who I am today. You know, a lot of decisions were made up to this point, and you know, regardless if it hurt or helped my career, from the outside looking in, I can, you know, confidently say that where I'm at today is the happiest that I've been in my life.
And just as you're getting comfortable, here comes a new offensive coordinator throwing a lot at you. What's that transition been like?
It's been really exciting. You know, it's a challenge, obviously, but it's not a challenge that I'm, you know, in fear of at all, because this will be my fifth or sixth offense I'm going in learning at this point. So, you know, with the bad side of transferring and being in different programs, you know, there also is a good side in the fact that I've had to, you know, test my capabilities as learning the offenses. So it's definitely a challenge, but it's one that I'm, you know, taking on full force, and I'm really excited about.
And the offense itself, how would you characterize it? Is wide open, a lot of different options? How would you characterize it?
It's a pretty stereotypical pro-style offense, in my mind, a shotgun one. You know, Coach Bell got his offense from Lindy Affonte at Indianapolis Colts, and then also from Steve Spurrier. So a little bit of, you know, air raid-ish kind of things. So, you know, I think just the best way to put it in my mind is that we have a lot of options, a lot of progression reads for the quarterbacks, and, you know, it gives us the opportunity to get the playmakers the ball, which is really exciting.
But the biggest factor to Blake's success this year could be attributed to his more stable environment, thanks to his biggest fans, his family.
I've been to a lot of different places, had a lot of different experiences in my college, you know, career up to this point. So this is definitely the most stable I've been at a place, and you know, with my family, obviously with my wife and my son, it's really nice being at a place where I truly feel at home at school, and then you know, being able to go home to my actual family is really reassuring.
What a fine young man with a great perspective on life and football. All right, when we come back, we'll take a look at the home opener. It's a big-time opponent. Stay with us.
Stay tuned for MOR Chronicle, USF Strong Spring Football 2019. You are watching MOR Chronicle, USF Strong Spring Football 2019.
And welcome back. Well, the 2019 USF schedule is one of the most ambitious in history, and it starts with a big-time slobber knocker against the Wisconsin Badgers. The Badgers will come south ranked in the preseason top 25 with a Heisman Trophy candidate and running back Jonathan Taylor. They also have the top-ranked dropback passer from the 2019 recruiting class in Graham Mertz. BYU comes calling for homecoming. They will already have played rival Utah at Tennessee, USC, and Washington before visiting the Bulls. Then it's a conference slate at home in November, Temple, Cincinnati, and Memphis, and then the annual War on I-4 in Orlando in the season finale. But all Charlie has on his mind is the Badgers.
When you have a team like Wisconsin, when you open up with a Wisconsin, then you knowing that now in summer condition and preseason camp, the players will be more focused and they'll be more locked in because now they have a really good football team. And what's really great is this, they're coming to our place. So it's a really good home opener for us and our fans.
And that's our show here from USF. A big thanks to the USF Athletic Department, the coaches and staffs. And we look forward to a tremendous 2019 season. I'm JP Peterson. Until next time, go Bulls.